Hi, this is Joachim for statisticsglobe.com, and in this video I'm going to show you how to draw heat maps in the R programming language. So in the video I'm going to use some example data that we can create here in lines 2 to 5 of the code. So if you run these lines of code, you can see that at the top right of R Studio a new data object appears. We can also have a look at this data by double-clicking on the data. And as you can see, our data contains 10 columns, 10 rows. And in these data cells, you can see a lot of numeric values. Now, if we want to draw a heat map in R, then we can use the heat map function, which is already provided by the basic installation of the R programming language. And within the heatmap function, we simply have to specify the name of our data, as you can see here in line 8 of the code. And if you run this code, you can see that at the bottom right of R Studio, a heatmap appears. And you can also see that the 10 columns and the 10 rows that we have in our data set are represented here in the heatmap. So what we also can do is we can modify some of the parameters of this heat map. So for instance, we could remove this dendrogram that you can see here at the top and on the left of the heat map by specifying the row v and the col v arguments within the heat map function to be equal to na, as you can see here in line 11 of the code. So if you run this line of code, you can see that at the bottom right, the heat map changes so that the dendrogram is not shown anymore. Yeah, what we also can do is we can change the colors of our heat map by specifying a range of colors. And this can be done here, as you can see here in line 14 of the code, with the color ramp palette function. And then within this function, we need to specify a starting color for the range and a finishing color for the range. So if you apply the color ramp palette function, as you can see here in line 14 of the code, a new data object is created, which is containing a function. And we can apply this function, as you can see here in line 15 of the code, to create a color range. So if we apply this function here, you can see that a range of colors is created. And then we can apply the heat map function again, as you can see here in line 15 of the code. And this time we are specifying the color argument within the heat map function to be equal to this range of 100 colors. And if you run line 15 of the code, you can see that our new heat map is shown in the color range that we have specified before. Yeah, so far we have only applied the heat map function of the base installation of the R programming language. However, there are many packages in the R programming language available, which are also providing functions for the creation of heat maps in R. And one of these packages is the ggplot2 package. So if we want to use the ggplot2 package, we first need to create some data that we can use in the ggplot2 package. The data needs to have a different structure than the data that we would insert into the heat map function. And in order to restructure our data, we can use the reshape package, as you can see here in lines 18 to 21 of the code. So if we want to use the reshape package, we would first need to install and load it, as you can see in line 18 and 19 of the code. I have installed the package already, so I'm just going to load it here with line 19 of the code. And then we can melt our data with the melt function, as you can see in line 21 of the code. And then a new data object appears at the top right. And this new data object has a long format. So we have three columns. X1 and X2 are representing the rows and the column combinations of our original data set. And the third column is representing the values of our previous data set. So now we can use the ggplot package after installing and loading the package, as you can see here in line 23 and 24 of the code. And then we can use the ggplot function in combination with the geomTile function. So if you run line 26 to 28 of the code, you can see that at the bottom right of our studio, a new plot appears, a new heat map appears. And this time, this heat map was created with the ggplot2 package. So you can also see that this style of the plot is similar to the typical ggplot2 package design that you already know. Also within the ggplot2 package, you have different ways how you can change the heat map. So one example that I want to show you here is shown in line 31 of the code. And in this case, we are changing the colors of the heat map with the scale fill gradient function. And within this function, we have to specify the starting value and the finishing value, or the starting color and the finishing color. So in this example, we are using green and black. And if you run this line of code, you can see that our new heat map is shown in the colors green and black. Yeah, another package that provides functions for the creation of heat maps is the plotly package. And again, we can install and load the package, as you can see here in lines 34 and 35 of the code. So after loading the package, we can access the function plotly, as you can see here in line 37 of the code. And within this function, we need to specify the data that we want to use. So this time we are using our original data again, and not the data that we have created before in example 4. And then within the plotly function, we need to specify the type of the plot to be equal to heat map. Now, if you run this line of code, you can see that at the bottom right, a new heat map is appearing. And what you also can see is that this heat map here is created in the viewer of our studio. So this is a little bit different compared to the plot window that we have seen before. So if you want to export these heat maps, you need to do it a little bit differently. This has pros and cons. So it's also a bit a matter of taste, which package you want to use. But this is another alternative for the creation of heat maps. Yeah, and also in the plotly package, we have alternatives how we can specify our plot. So this time I also want to show you how to change the colors of the heat map that we have created with the plotly package. And one option that is provided by the plotly function is the color scale. And here we can specify that we want to have gray scales by specifying color scale to be equal to grays. Now, if you run this code, you will see that our plot changes to be in grayscale. Yeah, so as you have seen, there are many alternatives for heat maps, for the creation of heat maps in the R programming language. However, if you want to learn more about this topic, you could check out my homepage, statisticsglobe.com, because on the homepage, I have recently published a tutorial on the creation of heat maps in R. And in this tutorial on the homepage, I'm explaining the R code of this video in some more detail. I will put a link to the tutorial in the description of this video, so you could check it out there. And if you have liked the video, of course, I would be very happy if you leave me a comment. And don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel to get notifications about videos that I'm releasing in future. That's it for this video. Thanks a lot. See you next time. Bye bye.